Big, it moves quickly, and it sits along 435. People are talking about this new attraction, and most are saying, what is that? KMBC 9 meteorologist Erin Little is live tonight to explain. Erin?
You take one quick glance at this thing that you see behind me, Larry, and you might think it's the latest art sculpture here in Kansas City, but it's actually the EAS Windjet 5. It's the first to debut in the entire world, and it's right here off 435 in Row.
People are gawking at it. I hope it doesn't cause any accidents on the freeway.
I'm curious as to just really what, you know, what it's supposed to be used for.
With six blades.
I've already had, just in the last day, had so many people call me.
Standing 80 feet tall.
It's the state of the art in wind technology.
It's the newest wind turbine to blow into Kansas City.
From an engineering perspective, it's really beautiful, very efficient, and looks great. Western Kansas and Iowa, you see the big turbines, and when I told all my friends we were going to have a turbine, you know, that's the picture they had.
But travelers along 435 in Row will see a completely different turbine. The EAS Windjet 5 is much smaller.
You can see the turbine spins slower, so you don't have the bird kill or the noise generation or the ice throw of a typical turbine.
But it still generates 5,000 watts of power.
We're going to use almost all the power we generate inside our building to light our building. But if we generate excess capacity, then it would go back into KCPL's grid.
A.L. Huber hopes this not only inspires, but shows people alternative energy is possible in Kansas City.
Well, that was kind of our hope, to take a leadership position and be in a position to help educate others how to integrate alternative energy into their buildings and into their lives.
And it only needs winds of about 6 miles per hour to create energy, which obviously it doesn't have tonight. But the more wind, the more power that it creates. So finally, Brian and I aren't the only ones closely watching storms that blow into Kansas City. Reporting live from Overland Park, back to you.